Tackle Talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, our story is on the right-hand side, top story of DrudgeReport.com. I keep saying right-hand side. It's on the left-hand side of DrudgeReport.com. And it deals with the fact that the National Weather Service in huge ammo purchase. Now, I talked about the fact that NOAA controls the Fisheries Office of Law Enforcement. Now, we've had guests on about how they're harassing surfers on the West Coast and telling people they can't have jet skis in the water now and all the rest of it for the marine mammals. And they're harassing people with boats, you name it. So I said, hey, I bet it's going to them. They're sending it to the West Coast, the East Coast. This is on top of the 1.4 billion rounds of ammo that the federal government has purchased last year. 250 million last year, 450 million 5 months ago, 750 million last week. But as usual, they're countering us. And listen to this, the Washington Post. National Weather Service ammunition solicitation triggers confusion. And then we're going to go to our guest, NOAA. Says there was a clerical error in the Fed Biz Ops announcement stating that the National Weather Service requested ammunition. The solicitation actually originated from NOAA Fisheries Office of Law Enforcement. Yeah, 15 to 25,000 rounds per office. That's listed there. Not the National Weather Service. See bottom of post for more details. Yeah, but it's under the National Weather Service. It's not a clerical error. They've always got to play a game to change the subject. There's 1.4 billion rounds. This is on top of that. Original post, weather forecasting or preparing for war. The National Weather Service seeks to buy 4,600 or 46,000 rounds of ammunition for semi-automatic pistols, says FedBiz website. In a solicitation head scratcher of explosive proportions. Well, no, it's not. The IRS just created a huge SWAT team. InfoWars, the website of libertarian talk show host. Hey, they actually got it right. Alex Jones, because usually if there's a Republican in, I'm a hardcore communist, the news says, because I don't like the Republicans. Or if there's a Democrat in, I'm a right-wing extremist. No, I'm just a constitutionalist libertarian. Freedom lover. He goes on, InfoWars, the website of libertarian talk show host Alex Jones says the ammunition being ordered is designed to cause maximum organ damage. And it goes on to quote us. So, again, now the National Weather Service is responding to the Washington Post and Drudge Report, picking up our story. That's a good place to start with Lou Rockwell of LouRockwell.com. Author, researcher, runs the very popular LouRockwell.com. They have an article out about licensing of gardens and lemonade stands in this great free nation we live in. And he's an American libertarian political commentator, activist, proponent of the Austrian School of Economics, and chair of the Ludwig von Mises Institute. He was also Ron Paul's congressional chief of staff, and he joins us right now to break all of this down. Some of the new stories on the site today, blaming guns and other inanimate objects, 80 million zombies, wrecking the Arab world, promoting crime in schools, get your money out now, Ron Paul's offenses against the state religion, the ghost of Joe McCarthy, Paul Ryan's principles, saying no to government loyalty oath, the crown of self-control, who killed the Lindbergh baby. They wreak havoc on your health. That's a few good articles. I ought to ask him what those are all about, even though I've read a couple of them today and linked to them at InfoWars.com. He joins us now looking at this. Lou, what do you make of checkpoints everywhere, TSA on the highways everywhere, warrantless checkpoints, TSA grabbing people's laptops and downloading the contents, police doing it, the general unfolding police state, drones all over the place. I videotaped one last week in Austin, flying around, surveilling things, and 1.4 billion, I keep saying million, 1.4 billion rounds of ammunition purchased in the last year. I looked it up. That's about 10 times what DHS purchased in previous years. What are they getting ready for Lou Rockwell?
Well, Alex, of course, that's what is that? More than four bullets per person in this country. You know, they're worried about insurrection, because as the government keeps getting more and more control in as you're talking about everything from the fisheries to the highways to schools, homes, businesses, churches, charities. They're taking more and more control, and of course, as the government gets bigger, it gets worse, it gets morally worse, and the people who rise to the top of the government become even worse, they become even more monstrous, and so they want more and more control. This is what they live for. They love doing this to people. They love crushing people. They love killing people. That's why they love wars so much, besides all the money they make. So but they also get more paranoid. They're constantly afraid that, you know, they're sort of like fleas on a dog, and they're always afraid that maybe the dog's going to scratch them off. So they arm themselves, and they have, you know, all these armored SWAT teams. Every government agency has got armored SWAT teams, as you so correctly point out. So the government is our enemy. I mean, I think that's what we have to realize. These people are not getting all these bullets to, quote unquote, defend us or protect us or the rest of the myths that they put out in Washington. It's to hurt us if we don't obey. So that's what they're afraid of, and they're continuing to turn the screws. So this is, of course, what we all fight about. This is what you fight against every day, me too, and so many other Americans are not willing to put up with this stuff that bothers the people in government, and they turn to violence. They use the word tool. You know, they always talk about their toolkit. They want another tool. The tool is the gun. So that's their one and only tool. Whether you refuse to pay or maybe forget to pay your library fine, and then you sufficiently resist paying the library fine, they claim the right to kill you over not paying your library fine. And of course, everything else that they look at, any document the government has you sign, it's menacing, it's predatory, they threaten to put you in jail over anything. This is a very nasty institution.
They behave like the mafia because they are the biggest mafia.
Well, don't criticize. At least the mafia gives us products that people want to buy voluntarily. I think the government's far worse than the mafia. Far more nasty, far more vicious, murdered infinitely more people than the mafia ever did.
I guess you're right. No, you're right. Government killed, according to the University of Hawaii study, 262 million people in the 20th century, not counting military deaths or deaths by military. I mean, that's more than anything. I mean, government's more deadly than cancer.
Well, you know, people, I always think Dick Cheney showed this, but they're all like this. They like killing people. You know, they like sending in the predator drones. Obama must enjoy that. Maybe he does it over his cereal in the morning, signs the death order, gets a kick out of it. The people who rise to the top in government like killing other people. That's it's a tough thing for the normal person who, of course, would never in a million years want to kill anybody else. But the people who rise to the top of government are killers. They're looters. They're very bad people.
Of course, that's what our founding fathers said, and we tried to follow their system, and it wasn't perfect, but it created more wealth than any other nation ever had. 4% of the world's population, we had more than half the wealth. Now, as the liberty goes out the door, like oxygen, our prosperity's going out. I want to pull back and look at the big picture, and then I want to get into Paul Ryan, Ron Paul, a whole bunch of articles, drones with Lou Rockwell, the icon from LouRockwell.com. But first, I want to go to the fact we have an article out at Infowars.com today. Rome burned, will we? By the way, LouRockwell.com is always welcome to carry any of our stuff if you want. We'd be honored. But I want to get your take on this, because I know you've written and talked about this, the parallels to the United States Empire and Rome. Give us your own historical and economically studied perspective on Rome burned, will we?
Well, you know, of course, this is something that you mentioned the founding fathers. They were very, very aware of. They, in many ways, sought to emulate the heroes of Republican Rome, and were very much concerned about what happened when it developed into a vicious empire. So, yeah, I mean, there are parallels, and not that they aren't exact, but with empire comes corruption, comes destruction, comes economic destruction, comes poverty, and comes the fall. So it happened to the British, it happened to the Romans, it happened to the Egyptians, the Assyrians, the Babylonians. I mean, go down the list of all the various empires. And they typically go out, as Ron Paul always points out, for economic reasons. Not so much that they lose militarily, First, they lose economically, then they lose militarily. So here we have the U.S., which, you know, despite all the wars it wages, is not very good at them. It has like a gigantic World War II style military, and they can't handle guys with AK-47s in Afghanistan who've got, you know, no drones, no planes, no tanks, you know, none of the equipment, none of the electronic surveillance equipment and so forth, and yet they can't beat them. So this is, I think, a sign of things to come. Romney and Obama, I think, are going to give us more wars, probably, I think, Romney worse than Obama in the foreign policy area, hard as that is to believe, and, of course, Paul Ryan, too. So, yeah, we headed down, and when Rome fell, you know, there was a very long period of decivilization, took a long time to build back up. It also happened when trade collapsed in the whole Mediterranean world because of the fights between the Muslims and the Christians. You know, so things go on for a very long time. It took a long time to rebuild. We have to hope that we're not going to end up in that sort of situation. But already, of course, we're poorer. Really, if you look at things with an unjaundiced eye and pay no attention to government propaganda, the average American family is no better off today than they were in the early 1970s in real terms. And that was when Nixon took us off the remnants of the gold standard and gave us the full fiat money, paper money, you know, baloney money system that we are suffering under, the whole world suffers under today, and is probably going to bring us all down today or in the near future.
Lou Rockwell, stay there. I want to come back and look at the world financial crisis, and banks are told, get ready for collapse. Government can't help you. Prepare yourselves. Why we see all this scurrying around, as you point out, our so-called military couldn't even hold Baghdad. How are they going to hold the United States, no matter how many billions of rounds of ammunition the bureaucrats have, with big sis up there waddling around?
In this unpredictable world, disaster can strike anyone. That's why an essential part of any emergency survival plan must be stove in a can. When power goes out and gas lines are down, the portable, safe, easy-to-use stove in a can cooks food up to 4 hours and boils water in as little as 5 minutes. Stove in a can comes with everything you need. The stove, fuel, even waterproof matches, all in a compact, durable, heavy-duty container. Plus, the all-natural, non-explosive, 100% waterproof fuel source can be stored indefinitely. Say goodbye to the hassle and danger of propane, lighter fluid, or gas. Stock up now and protect your family with Stove in a Can, starting out at $29.99. Special bundle offers now available with a 100% satisfaction guarantee or your money back. Order yours today at stoveinacan.com. That's stoveinacan.com.
Now, guys, you know what TGen can do for you. Boosting testosterone is no small feat for a man of any age. But do you know what happens when you boost testosterone and nitric oxide at the same time? We are talking a whole nother level of performance. Boosting nitric oxide is how the popular pharmaceuticals work to increase performance. And during the Chamonix Summer Clearance Sale, you will get 3 bottles of the brand new Nitro Boost Nitric Oxide Enhancer absolutely free. It's the best offer you'll hear on the radio this summer. Increase your sexual desire, muscle growth with exercise, and add Nitro Boost for a new level of performance. And amazingly, during this summer clearance, it's free. Call 800-577-8644, 800-577-8644, and get the new Nitro Boost absolutely free with your TGen today. And even this crazy sale comes with an incredible 90-day money-back guarantee. So don't wait. Call now. 800-577-8644, 800-577-8644.
Hi there. My name is Frank Bates. What I'm about to tell you in the next 60 seconds could get me in a lot of trouble. I just created a free video presentation at 123coverup.com that exposes the electricity monopolies and government agencies for what they really are, incompetent, lying crooks that are counting on your ignorance and fear to keep your power bills criminally high. Some have called this a conspiracy. Others have called it a cover-up, and you will be shocked to find out how deep the conspiracy goes. My video at 123coverup.com exposes the truth and shows you the secret of how I beat them and how you can beat them too. Watch the controversial video that thousands of other smart patriots have already seen in the last 3 months. Go to 123coverup.com and discover one weird trick to slash your power bill and protect your home. Go watch my video now at 123coverup.com before they force me to shut it down. Again, that's 123coverup.com.
Now at DeseretFoodStore.com, sign up for a one-month supply of delicious food for only $99 with free shipping. That's right, only $99. Gourmet restaurant-style meals with a 30-year shelf life. Packaged in heavy-duty Mylar bags for easy transport and freshness. Meals like stroganoff, lasagna, teriyaki, five-bean chili, granola pancakes, and much more. Visit DeseretFoodStore.com, spelled D-E-S-E-R-E-T, foodstore.com, or call 801-444-1444. Food for now, food for life.
In a coming-apart world, you need something to keep it tied together. That something is Atwood Rope, the highest quality rope made in the USA from exotic braids for military, rescue, arborists, shipyards, towline, or boating. Quality rope at affordable prices you and your customers can depend on. Find a dealer or shop online at atwoodrope.net. Enter promo code RADIO to receive 100 feet of 550 paracord free with purchase. Atwood Rope, working to keep the world tied together.
Rockwell is our guest. The voice you're hearing is that of, well, me, Alex Jones. He's with us for the rest of the hour. Lou, I want to cover the waterfront with you and pick your brain. And I want to get into the Republican-Democratic field this year, Ron Paul, where all that's going. Paul Ryan, obviously Romney picked the wrong Paul, but I don't blame him for not picking Rand, because Rand's a lot better than Paul Ryan, so we know why that happened. But getting back to the issue of the world economy right now, from the perspective of an economist who heads up the Von Mises Institute, where are things going? And how can the very people that got us into this crisis get us out of it when their answer is give them more power and more corporate welfare?
Alex, I should mention, I'm not an economist, although I think about economics and write about it and read about it. But I think we can, I think and your listeners know the serious trouble. They keep claiming they're patching up the euro in the eurozone. It's not actually happening. So maybe they're going to just continue. Maybe they're, if the Germans let them, and I fear the Germans are going to let them, they're going to just print unlimited number of euros to buy the useless bonds of the countries that have issued them to the big banks. Because, of course, as with all economic troubles these days, the big banks are in back of what's happening in Europe. Because it's not, they're not bailing out Greece, they're not bailing out Italy or Spain. They're bailing out the big banks that hold the bonds of these countries. And the so-called technocratic prime ministers that have been installed in Italy and Greece and probably in other countries too, and at the European Central Bank, these people typically come from Goldman Sachs. So this is these are the sorts of people who are in back of this. They want the people of Europe to be further impoverished so the banks can live it up. Same thing happens in our own country, of course. We live in also in a bankocracy. So they can keep printing up. Fed prints up all this, prints up trillions. But this does have an effect when, you know, it's made us all poorer already. How much poorer are we going to be? How much of a police state and a military state and a military junta, whatever the government is in Washington, I'm not exactly sure of what it is. Certainly is not anything like... was talked about by Thomas Jefferson.
Sure, and Lou, let me just stop you to be specific. I knew that you're not technically an economist, but you head up a group that's made up of a bunch of economists. I mean, yeah. You wouldn't call Ron Paul an economist, but he writes books about it and studies it. He's a lay economist. It's like I could go out and be a preacher. People call me the preacher, but I didn't go to seminary to be a preacher, though I did sit through a lot of Sunday school. My point is you head up a group that is a consortium of economists, correct?
Yes, of course, that's right.
Okay, so I mean, my point is, I see you as a real economist. I mean, it's like, I don't have a degree in shooting, but with a good rifle, I can shoot bullseye at 500 yards pretty easy. So wow. I'm not officially a sharpshooter, but I am. But I mean, just getting back to that, you are heavily into economics, and you consult with a bunch of economists, so I wanted your pulse on that.
Well, there's trouble. I mean, we're not, the pulse is a little bit harder to feel these days. Because of what the government is doing, we have... You know, in the U.S. government, and the U.S. government has got its clones in Britain and in Europe and so many other countries in the rest of the world. The U.S. government is the biggest richest, most powerful government ever to exist in the history of humankind. I mean, there's never been anything like this before. So we are really in new territory, and new territory of disaster, I'm afraid. I noticed that Jim Rogers the other day thought that there was a collapse coming after the November elections because of all the money printing that's going on, both in Europe and in Asia and in the United States, of course, too. So I don't know. So I don't know what the timing is, but they are undermining. They're like a bunch of termites. They're eating out the foundation of the house. When the house is going to collapse, I don't know. But if the termites aren't stopped, we can be sure the house is going to collapse. So,
and then when the collapse does start to happen, as it's already started, they pose as saviors. So how do you stop them from turning us into a pure third world despotic system from the implosion that they've created?
Well, you know, that's a great question. I think the first thing we have to do is educate ourselves. We all have to know some economics. I would recommend something like Henry Hazlitt's Economics in One Lesson, which was published in the late 1940s, but it's just as fresh today as it was then. And if you learn some economics, it enables you to see through the government lies. You can see through the smokescreen that they try to generate to cover their crimes. So you can understand. So everybody needs to understand some economics, first of all. Then we need to, you know, to resist. We need to withdraw our consent. We need to talk about what's going on. We need to listen to shows like yours. We need to read all the right books. And mentally resist. Actually, mentally resisting is, you know, I would say, by the way, don't vote is one thing you can do. They're very anxious that we vote. They want that mandate from us. They don't care who you vote for. Ultimately, of course, there are interest groups.
Tell you what, stay there. Explain that. Let's get into this current election on the quick break. We'll be right back.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run.
Threatening the sale of nano silver products. You can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs generator. Very easy to follow step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure, but if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way. You actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com. Or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
Defending freedom and basic liberty. Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. Back Sundays 4 to 6. And don't forget InfoWars Nightly News. By the way, you know, we promote what we use and believe in, and I have found the best vitamin and mineral supplement preparation company out there. They've been around for more than 15 years. And it's all available discounted at InfoWarsTeam.com. You can go to InfoWars.com and see a new information video we put out showing the side-by-side comparisons of Aaron Dykes, myself, and others, and the incredible weight loss and health benefits of the products at InfoWarsTeam.com. Deficiency of vitamins and minerals causes obesity. Because it makes you want to then eat more and more because you're eating empty calories. And lo and behold, government won't tell anybody this. And government-controlled big medicine doesn't want to tell you this because, well, it's a rigged system. So check out that new video up at InfoWars.com right now. Very powerful video. And continuing, there's a lot of other news up there on the site. FAA documents how drones over U.S. pose huge security risk. This has now been leaked. A group did FOIA requests and got some of it, but more of it's come out, how dangerous it is. I want to get into the election and the two-party system and the rest of this, Lou, and where you see things going and other issues I know you're hot to talk about. But first off, what is this obsession with supersonic cruise missiles? I guess it's about military domination. But this you know, 1.4 million rounds of ammo against us. The FAA saying, yeah, 30,000 drones, and they're starting to arm them. Is this all part of government wanting big, giant marble buildings to make us feel small, and drones, and letting us know we're being watched, and face scanning cameras, and TSA abusing us? What is all that about? Just the simple act of domination? Because they seem to think it's scaring people. I don't see that happening. I see it upsetting people, and that's why they're getting politically involved, exposing the system. That's why they're out buying guns at record numbers. What would you say the mood of the country is right now, and why is government obsessed with all these armaments?
Well, I think it's true that people are getting upset. They ought to be upset. Even Hitler and Stalin didn't make, you know, be able to feel up people's children and wives and so forth in the airport. I mean, this is, you know, and most people just accept this, or at least they go along with it. Maybe they don't see any other way out. But I think there is increasing resistance. People are angry. They should be angry. And as you say, of course, people are buying every time there's a one of these incidents like in the Batman shooting or whatever, there's vast increases in gun sales. People want to be armed. They want to have a gun in their home, and of course they should. They should be armed. It's a great thing to have law-abiding, good people armed. And as we know, it cuts down crime rates, private crime. Doesn't much affect government crime, of course, but it does cut down private crime, which is a wonderful benefit. But yeah, the government wants us all to. You only have to go to. I don't recommend going to Washington. But if you do go to Washington, D.C., take a look at the buildings. They absolutely are all built to make you feel small and make you impressed and in awe of the power and glory of the government. So all this stuff. Because it also has to do with fearing the people, but they want to make us scared of them, they want to make us scared of phony foreign enemies, and they want to make us obey. They want us to be rubbed and pushed down to be pushed down to bow down to the government, love the government, worship the government, fear the government, give it all our money, give it our children for its wars, and so forth.
Well, sure, there's so many progressives who are well-meaning people, but they've never really run a business. Talking to them, they always come out of academia, come out of government. They're disconnected from the real world and how stuff really works. And they always have these grand utopian views, but all they ever deliver is hell on earth. History shows that, and we repeat it over and over again. Let me get into this subject and then into election 2012 and the point you're chomping at the bit to cover, Paul Ryan and the rest of it. And that's false flag staged events. I know everything isn't staged, but a lot of things have been staged, like Gulf of Tonkin, Operation Ajax, Gladio, Northwoods, the list goes on and on. Or at least in many cases they use crises They don't want those to go to waste, as the White House Chief of Staff, Rahm Emanuel, said, former Chief of Staff, now Mayor of Chicago. But now we see the spectacle of Al-Qaeda flags over Libya, Al-Qaeda flags over Rebel Herald areas of Syria. We see the CFR fellow writing for them last week saying, we need Al-Qaeda. That's a quote. They're heroes. They're doing a great job. So the TSA needs to abuse my family and take them into a private rape room if I want to fly. But Al-Qaeda is good in Libya and Syria, and NATO's working with the criminals out of Saudi Arabia. And then on top of that, I had Larry Pratt on a few weeks ago, and he said, look, if the Obama criminals would stage Fast and Furious, that's killed thousands, why wouldn't they stage the Batman shooting when you've got reports of multiple gunmen, multiple gas masks, the cover-ups, the government psychiatrist? I mean, we know they do stuff like this. So what do you say about false flag terror and our so-called government publicly running Al-Qaeda?
Well, you know, as you know, all governments, especially police states, employ agents provocateurs. They seek to they cause crimes. They cause terrorist incidents in order to get the public all hepped up, and also maybe to expose people that they fear themselves. Who knows about that? But their main thing is to control their own public, their own cash cows, their own taxpayers. That's the people they are really concerned about controlling. So yeah, they of course they run false flags. We can't sometimes know whether things are false flags or not. Obviously, we can't tell what's coming. But is this government or any big government capable of false flag operations? Of course. There's, you know, if they don't do something evil, it's either because they haven't thought about it or because they think it's not prudent for themselves at the time. They never have the reaction, oh gosh, we can't do that, it's wrong. That never passes the mind of anybody in Washington, maybe with the exception of, I hate to think of Ron Paul as being part of Washington, but obviously Ron Paul and a handful of other guys are, there are good guys, but most of them, so Fast and Furious was a false flag thing. I think it also had to do with the fact that the CIA runs the international drug trade.
Bingo! That actually came out in a few papers, as you know, because you're so informed, that they were shipping drugs back. It wasn't just guns in. It was basically an Iran-Contra part two.
And of course, they're also destroying Mexico. I mean, ever since George Bush forced the Mexicans, who of course are in effect a colony of the U.S., forced them to have a drug war down there. There have been more than 50,000 people killed, horrendous damage to Mexican society, and it's all, of course, being either staged or run or at least cooperated with by the DEA and the CIA.
Yeah, why doesn't the Mexican kleptocracy kick out the big banks that run them?
Well, because they're all making money. They're also afraid, right? They're afraid of being killed. Because certainly the U.S. government doesn't hesitate to assassinate people. We're now having that openly talked about, and maybe that's a good thing that they are openly talking about it. But they've done this, forever. If somebody is too much trouble, they'll kill them.
The Washington Post even
had the operating table, or shoot down their helicopter or their plane. Mysteriously, has something wrong with the fuel line, and it goes down. This stuff happens all the time. The government is a bunch of killers. So we always have to remember that. Doesn't mean that every incident, bad incident, is because of the government, because of course they're also hugely incompetent. Thank goodness. But in terms of things that are, there's nothing morally beyond them. So false flags, this horrendous damage they're doing to the Mexicans, Fast and Furious, all this stuff. Of course, there's a million and one of these things. Who knows what else they're planning? These are bad people. Don't commit the flag and the Pledge of Allegiance and all that stuff. These are bad people. The government are bad people.
Well, they're also maniacs. I mean, I couldn't imagine putting my employee's stuff in the bathroom over and over again and then calling an employee up and saying, get in here and give me sexual favors right now. Or only hiring people that were my sexual persuasion, as we now see coming out in these lawsuits. It just really shows a disconnect But we see this in every culture and every history with the power mad. They're all, look at Caligula marrying his horse. What do you make of the big scandal with Big Sis?
Well, of course, this is a great peek into the government. And there are plenty, by the way, of decent people in the government. They just don't rise to the top. The people who rise to the top, whether it's at the DHS order, you know, they're not concerned with security or the rest of the lies they tell. They're concerned with sex, power, and money. So those are the three things that motivate the power elite and the people in the government, the people at the top of the government. So this is not just DHS. This is the whole government. This stuff happens in the Pentagon. It happens in the CIA. It happens at the FAA. Go down the whole alphabet from hell. All these are like this. So how wonderful we're having this pointed out about the DHS. Maybe it will have the scales fall from people's eyes about the nature of this thing. And it's great to look up, by the way, the headquarters of DHS. It looks like something out of Mordor. And it's the former St. Elizabeth's Mental Hospital where political prisoners have been held. And they converted it into their headquarters. It's a very scary, and it's, of course, intended to be scary. Like every, whether the way they paint the cop cars these days, the way they dress the cops, everything is intended to scare you. When I'm thinking of cops and dress, there was a great period at one time in Menlo Park, California, where a bunch of liberals got in power, and they had the cops dress in gray slacks, blue blazers with a city patch on their pocket. The whole nature of cop-civilian interaction changed. All of a sudden, they weren't marching around like an occupying force, and it was a great development. The cop union, of course, very much against it. Conservatives got back in, and they succeeded in repealing this and putting everybody back into military-like uniforms.
Well, there's one problem, too, when they standardize it and make it a military uniform, and now the cops are calling us civilians. They're civilians, too. You don't want them to be military. Military is an occupying army. This is all 101. Lou Rockwell, let's look at this election. So many people know that Mitt Romney was for gun bans and abortion and open borders and globalism and carbon taxes and banker bailouts. Paul Ryan, banker bailouts, no child left behind. I mean, the list literally goes on and on, but he was held up as a conservative savior by Rush Limbaugh for his plan to cut welfare to the general, you know, poor people, which is fine with me because it just makes them dependent and screws up the economy. But what about cutting military spending like Ron Paul has said? And people are like, oh, no, you've got to just worship Paul Ryan. Well, I was told I needed to worship Obama, and he was going to fix things. And now we're hearing about Ryan mania. I mean, is there no end to this? Are mainline conservatives as stupid as Obama supporters?
Sure, they're stupid. A lot of them are just wrong, too. They believe, they worship the military. They worship the police. They worship the national security state. They love drones. They love all this stuff. So, you know, if you think of the Tea Party, there's a bunch of them who are Ron Paulians. But there's also a bunch of them who are, you know, Sarah Palinites, Rush Limbaughites, and so forth, who believe in the whole regime. And so they applaud the wars, they applaud the killing. They love that stuff, and they think it'll never happen because they think they'll never be arrested, they'll never be tortured, they'll never be tasered. Good luck to them. But so, you know, they are stupid or they're wrong. They're ill-educated. They don't understand the nature of politics. They don't understand history. They don't understand economics. And so they're, yeah, and they also just buy into rhetoric. It's, how stupid are people? I think of this when there's always the rhetoric for a new war. And of course, they're running a war against Syria right now, allied with Al Qaeda, which of course was created by the U.S. government to go up against the Russians in Afghanistan. It's when the U.S. employed Osama bin Laden and all those guys. So they're bad, they're good, they're bad, they're good. You know, this is the old switcheroo to keep everybody off balance. But Paul Ryan, anybody, all you have to do is look at his record. He voted for every rotten thing that's ever gone through the Congress if the Republicans were supporting it. And of course, the Republicans did support all the rotten stuff, whether it's the bank bailouts, as you said, No Child Left Behind, Medicare Part D, the permanency of the Patriot Act, the NDAA, SOMA, CISPA, I mean, all these horrendous internet control laws and so forth. This guy is for the expansion of the DHS. He's for more war. He's for bigger and bigger military spending. And by the way, his so-called cuts in domestic spending consists in lowering the projected increases. So it's all a trick. He's a phony. Your listeners, of course, understand this, that all these people are phonies. So we see the sheeple cheering on Romney, who looks to me like he belongs in a Nazi party uniform.
that's
you know, right fascism and left fascism with Obama, right fascism, that's our choice. And we have another fascist in Paul Ryan. So the fact that he uses tricky rhetoric, that he uses libertarian or Ayn Randian rhetoric to disguise his devotion to the total central state and the global empire, well, it's just another political trick. So I'd urge people, if anybody's thinking this is a good guy, or because they're portraying him as Ron Paul, there is only one Ron Paul. This is, of course, the phony Ron Paul. This is the... This is the devil dressed up as Ron Paul. This guy is a very bad guy. He's a total neocon. He's controlled by all the bad forces. And his wife, by the way, also was a lobbyist for the big pharma before she married him. So this is a connected family, and they've done very well. It's recently came out that when he was briefed by Bernanke right at the beginning of the banking crisis, he sold his stocks. That he knew was going to go, that he'd been briefed, were going to go down, Wachovia and Citibank in particular, and he bought a lot of stock in Goldman Sachs, which he'd been told was going to go up. So, of course, this is the way these guys get rich. He's a very powerful guy. He's a complete phony. He's a very bad guy. Who else would Romney pick? Romney is a very bad guy.
Well, yeah, talk about phony.
I mean, torture, concentration camps, everything. These are very bad men.
Well, no, Romney will do
Biden and Obama.
Sure. I mean, Romney will do stuff like call on his neighbors that are smoking pot, call the police, but then come in and take over companies and strip them and destroy them and then prance around all day. I've noticed really evil people will have this act that they're Mr. Goody Two-Shoes. I mean, look at the whole Sandusky thing. Look at that. Look at how these universities basically become little governments. And then now the head of Penn State has been sent off to work at Homeland Security. So now if you cover up for pedophile rings, you don't go to jail, you go to Homeland Security.
Well, of course, it was a cover-up. That's why Louis Freeh was sent in to cover it up. The governor of Pennsylvania, the Republican governor of Pennsylvania, when he was attorney, he was attorney general, and a lot of this stuff was first being talked about, why didn't he do anything? And then he was personally pressing, right when this whole scandal blew up, for $3 million to be given to the Sandusky Foundation by the state of Pennsylvania. Why was he doing that? So there's a million questions that are not being asked. Louis Freeh is a famous cover-up artist and a creep for the government, sent in to cover. This is the way they operate, of course. They cover for the power elite and step on the regular people.
No, exactly. It's even coming out in major papers now that it's what we thought it was, a pedophile ring pimping kids out to these degenerates. I want to look at Obama himself, the warmonger, when we come back with Lou Rockwell of LouRockwell.com. I'm Alex Jones of InfoWars.com.
Don't throw away leftovers. Instead, throw all your leftovers, vegetable peels, eggshells, coffee grounds, pizza crusts, and more into the Bokashi. If you love to garden and compost...
We've talked about the Republicans, but what about Obama? I mean, where is the so-called left that are bad on a lot of things, but at least we're anti-war torture? Now they're kind of like, hey, torture people, drones, murder, death, Al-Qaeda, kill everybody. Al-Qaeda's good. We love war. It's our president. He's tough. And I see Democratic leaders bragging, saying, see, we're warmongers. We're tough. What is it about decadent, affected people that they think murder and death is cool and powerful?
Well, first of all, of course, political parties are about lying. The government is about lying. And the political parties that are part of the government are about lying. So Republicans pretend to be for lower spending, for example. But of course, when they're in power, the spending goes way up. Democrats pretend to be pro-peace. And although I must say, I was shocked that a few of them actually turned out to be pro-peace. And you're exactly right. They're all fanatically, if their guy's in the White House, they're fanatically for the worst war crimes.
They endorse them.
They cheer them on.
And again,
people who are in government, and the political parties, by the way, are part of the government. They're not separate from the government.
It's why, for example,
it's impossible to take over a political party from the outside. Take over the Department of Justice while you're at it. You can't do it. You can just refuse to be part of it, but you can't actually take them over.
And like cancer, they're programmed to totally take over. So how long until they fully implode everything and start trying to use their 1.4 billion bullets on us?
Well, I think, again, I started to say this before, but the government is so big that it's out of control, even internally. The problems of bureaucracy, Ludwig von Mises wrote about this in his great little book, Bureaucracy, many years ago. But the problems of bureaucracy, and there's never been a bureaucracy like the U.S. government, so they're becoming more and more trouble, but more and more trouble, too. I always think of them like a blind, vicious dog. So if you happen to get in their jaws or you're stepped on or whatever, you're dead. But you don't have to be.
Ooh, that's a good way to describe it. It is like a giant blind Cujo, and it is stumbling around foaming, but it could just implode at any time. I've noticed that historically.
No, that's right. Governments have come down in the past. As our government becomes bankrupt, the government is bankrupt, and it's trying to bankrupt us too. Of course, at the same time, and as its own troops, and this happens when empires start to come down. Its own troops don't obey it. So I'd like to think that if American troops were ordered to shoot American citizens, they would actually refuse to do it. I'm keeping my fingers crossed if that's the case. But I think the government can't be sure of them. They can't be sure of us. They can't be sure of anything. That's why they're all scared. They're actually scared of us.
And that's good. That's good.
Preening themselves in their uniforms, and they're so strong and so wonderful. And they're actually little Casper Milquetoast, albeit with vampire teeth.
That's a funny image. Casper Milquetoast, albeit with vampire teeth. No, I agree with you. But they're dangerous because they're cornered rats. But we actually have the initiative. They know that. And their own bureaucracy is starting to fall apart. And a lot of military and police are waking up. If they call for martial law, it might be their Waterloo, like Romania with Ceausescu.
Well, it could be. And I think they are very worried about us. They're worried about their own people. And they should be worried. So it's an entirely illegitimate operation that lives off lies and theft and killing and so forth. And governments have come down. It is in danger of imploding. I should say in danger from their standpoint of imploding. It would be a great day for us.
Exactly. Lou Rockwell, thank you so much. Casper Milquetoast, thank you. With vampire teeth. That's Obama.